The Maryland Department of Natural Resources launched a Resiliency Through Restoration initiative back in 2017, and we've been working very hard to design and implement nature-based practices. And the West River Methodist Center is our first constructed Resiliency Through Restoration project.
So the project helped us to replace a failing bulkhead along approximately 900 feet of our property right through the heart of camp.
So the bulkhead was failing and they all have a finite life, but at beaches like this one, it is like perpetual.
We were able to create a resilient shoreline that can withstand and work with the adverse effects of climate change and these larger storm events. But also it's a water quality project with regards to taking stormwater pipes offline and putting them through a sand-bedded wetland system that ultimately feeds into the river.
The dynamic living shoreline with headland features is a design with a bit of a nature-based touch on it.
Those cobble bars that are planted up, they're called whale tails, that's for lack of a better term, but they have gaps in between, they form these natural embayments, and that embayment does the heavy lifting for protecting the shoreline.
With regards to the shingle beach, which is right adjacent to the headland structures, this part of the shoreline was largely protected by an offshore marina, and we wanted to use the lightest touch possible.
And shingle beaches are ubiquitous across the world, and you can do a larger stretch without rock structures. They tend to be more stable than a traditional sand beach.
The last part about this dynamic living shoreline, which may separate it from other shorelines, is the fact that we incorporated the upland stormwater management into the project.
We recognize that communities are grappling with climate change impacts like nuisance flooding, sea level rise, storm surge, and erosion. But we also recognize that many of our urban and inland communities are grappling with the impacts of precipitation, more intense and more frequent rain events. So we're working with communities to address shoreline conditions, but also to address stormwater. One of the practices that we're looking into is the regenerative stormwater conveyance system, which is behind me here. This practice allows us to trap and infiltrate and treat stormwater before it's released into our Chesapeake Bay.
The Living Shoreline is a great opportunity for just some nature center playing around outside with the summer campers and a little bit of environmental education too that we just kind of can slide in there without them even realizing that they're learning. And so by teaching kids about specifically what was done, we can also then take it and say, what can you do in your own schools or neighborhoods?
So this was a big part in helping our campers be able to give back and help to take care of this waterfront that we're on and be able to pay it forward for generations to come.